Hi all, welcome to Smart Catalyst. Recently, IC Mode had released a new report on Hindu Kush Himalayas. The report was titled Hindu Kush Himalaya Assessment Report. The findings of the report indicate the negative fallout of global warming. Let's have a brief look into the findings of this report. The Hindu Kush Himalaya Assessment Report was released by International Center for Integrated Mountain Development. This ICMOD is a regional intergovernmental learning and knowledge sharing center serving as a knowledge institution for Hindu Kush Himalayas. Hindu Kush Himalayan region represents the mountain ranges that continues from Afghanistan, which ends at Myanmar. This ICMOD has 8 regional member countries, say Afghanistan, Bangladesh, Bhutan, China, India, Myanmar, Nepal, and Pakistan. This organization is devoted to sustainable mountain development. The organization was established in the year 1983 and the headquarters of ICMOD is in Kathmandu. As we mentioned earlier, sharing of information and sharing of knowledge are the chief commodities of the center. By creating awareness, by providing knowledge and information, they create awareness among the public about the importance of Himalayan region. This way, they are crucial in providing sustainable development solution for the people living in that region. Also, the reports released by ICMOD acts as a guiding light for policymakers. This is a basic about ICMOD. Before getting into the findings of the report, it is important for us to know about the importance of this Hindu Kush Himalayan region. As we mentioned earlier, this Hindu Kush Himalayan region comprises of 8 countries from Afghanistan to Myanmar. Also, it has important peaks of the world. Karakoram Pamir Wakhan Peak, Kailash Ranges, Mount Everest, Kanchenjunga, the far eastern Himalayas along the northeastern part of India and a few parts of Myanmar, and Chirapunji Chittagong. These are all biodiversity rich areas. Apart from having biodiverse rich areas and comprising a vast number of people living along the mountain ranges, it also acts as an important source for perennial rivers of the South Asian region. This Hindu Kush Himalayan region supports 10 major rivers. The 10 major rivers are Amudarya, Indus, Tarim, Ganges, Brahmaputra, Airavati, and Salween. These are the important rivers arising from Hindu Kush Himalayan region. These factors indicate the importance of Hindu Kush Himalayan region in South Asia. The Hindu Kush Himalayan region has geographical, environmental, cultural, economical, and social importance in the South Asian region. With the threat of climate change looming all over the world, there are few regions in the planet having maximum vulnerability. And one of that region is Himalayan region. Himalayan region is third only to the poles, and it is rightly known as third pole. This is because the Himalayas is the world's most vulnerable region to climate change after the poles. The report says that the Hindu Kush Himalayan region has lost 15% of its glaciers since 1970s, and with the continuing climate change scenario, the mountain ranges are expected to lose another 15-20% by end of this century. They have studied 3 different cases. The first case is the climate prognosis on Hindu Kush Himalayan region is studied by the ICMOD based on 3 factors, which is again based on emission level and the rise in temperature. The Hindu Kush Himalayan region has a total area of 4.2 million square kilometer, and it acts as home to 4 biodiversity hotspots, and it's 35,000 plus plant species, 200 plus animal species. We saw in the earlier slide that the Hindu Kush Himalayan glaciers, they act as a source for major river basins of the world. And with the glaciers melting in a rapid pace, leads to escalation in reduced water flow in the rivers in the future. Which in turn leads to acute water stress, thereby leading to migration and climate change induced conflicts all over the South Asian region. And this reduced water flow has implications on food security and economy of the country. One of the important river originating from Hindu Kush Himalayan region is Ganges. The Gangetic Basin alone supports an all 580 million population. They are all dependent on Ganges for their economic activities, be it the primary activities like agriculture, or the secondary activities like industry, or the tertiary activities like services sector, especially tourism. They are all based on the health of the Ganges River. If at all there is going to be a problem in glacial melting, it is going to affect the social, cultural, economic factor of the people living along the river Ganges. This indicates the danger lying ahead if we are not going to act on to curtail the glacial melting at rapid pace. This is not the first time that Himalayan region has been studied to indicate the vagaries of climate change. In 2007, IPCC released its fourth assessment report. In that report, based on few unchecked sources, they claimed that Himalayan glaciers would melt down completely by year 2035, and this created huge uproar among the scientific community. And after this failed experiment, no international agency released a report on impact of climate change on Himalayan region. Now, ICMOD, since it is focusing on creating awareness by spreading knowledge and information, has released this report by studying few factors as we discussed earlier. An alarming indicator is that the number of cold nights in the past decade has declined by one night, and at the same time, the warm nights are increasing at 1.7 nights per decade. This indicates the level of global warming happening in the Himalayan region. These negative impacts of global warming has been already witnessed in the Himalayan region. The southeast monsoon has become unpredictable. This is just a starting. This unpredictable southeast monsoon is a worrying sign for the future to come. The assessment report suggests that even if the countries are complying with the Paris target, the temperature rise in Hindu Kush Himalayan region would be higher than the global average temperature. This is because of elevated landscape of the Hindu Kush Himalayan region. Since they are a mountainous region, the amount of sunlight received by them is higher than the amount of sunlight received by the plain region. This way, the temperature rise would be more in Hindu Kush Himalayan region. And this temperature rise would lead to loss of 36% of glaciers by 2100. As we discussed earlier, the Hindu Kush Himalayan region supports crucial river basin supporting 916 million people, and of them 580 million people live along the Ganges river basin. Reduced water flow is a crisis for the future, and the problem in the near horizon is increased flow. Even in last year we witnessed flood in Himalayan region. Assam, we had disastrous floods from the rivers originating from Himalaya. For example, in Bihar, in Assam, we saw devastating floods. These disastrous floods in the states of Bihar and Assam were caused by overflow of water. The report suggests that the higher glacial melts in the near future will lead to increased water flow till 2050 and 60. We may witness more climate change induced disasters if the glacial melts are continuing at a faster pace. And towards the end of the century, as we discussed earlier, the water flow levels in these important South Asian rivers will drastically reduce, affecting agricultural output, and it will also has impact on non-consumptive use such as hydropower generation. Perennial rivers at the foothills of Himalayas, they are used as an important source for generating hydel power. With reduced water flow, hydel power usage may also come down. This is another consequence of glacial melting happening in Hindu Kush Himalayan region. The report warns that the lack of adequate action with regards to dams and the equitable sharing of hydropower benefits with mountain people and lack of robust transboundary cooperation for international rivers can lead to deepening of social inequities and thereby heightening the chances of conflict. Social inequities are caused by lack of equilibrium in the society. When climate change induced hazards are happening, this is going to create disrupt the already existing equilibrium. When there is a change in equilibrium, there will be social inequities. This way, the melting of glaciers has also gotten social consequences, rising the chances of conflict in the region. So we saw the various findings of the report, and the report has also suggested few ways forward, thereby mitigating the impacts caused by melting of glaciers in Hindu Kush Himalayan region. The policy makers must start looking at the economic valuation of ecosystems seriously. There are various roles played by an ecosystem. They have cultural role, they have a protective role, they have a producing role, and what the policymaker are doing is that they see ecosystem as an economic player. The other dimensions and the other functions of ecosystem has to be valued in a serious manner. The second way forward is to have collaboration and cooperation between transboundary countries like China, Nepal and India. These countries do cooperate with each other while on constructing infrastructure facilities like roads, dams and all. At the same time, they should also have the same zeal, they should also have the same cooperation in order to conserve this Himalayan region. The third point is based on building a sustainable forest-based economy in Himalayan states. The fourth point is about providing economic sustainability to the people living in the region. In order to do that, local organic agriculture has to be promoted. And the produce coming out of that organic agriculture has to be marketed as a specialty, high value, premium produce. And tourism is an important revenue generator for the countries in Hindu Kush Himalayan region. And the tourism should be focused on ecosystem based tourism, which leads to development with safeguards to the environment. This has to be considered. The last point suggested by the report is that the nations should build policies for sustainable urbanization in the mountains. Considering the ecological and environmental importance of Himalayas, the government of India, in its National Action Plan on Climate Change, has provided a separate mission for sustaining the Himalayan ecosystem. The National Action Plan on Climate Change was launched in the year 2008. It has 8 specific missions on 8 specific areas, and one important area is National Mission for Sustaining the Himalayan Ecosystem. It is a multi-pronged, cross-cutting mission across various sectors. It studies the changing under the scheme. This mission contributes to sustainable development of the country by closely observing the changes happening in Himalayas and providing adaptation action required for protecting Himalayas. The mission also seeks to facilitate formulation of appropriate policy measures, and by creating these appropriate policy measures, time-bound action programs helping the Himalayan region to sustain ecological resilience and ensure the continued provisions of key ecosystem services by the mountain ranges. This mission is under the control of Ministry of Science and Technology. Though the Ministry of Science and Technology has a central role to play with this mission, the other planning agencies like the Indian Himalayan States, other governmental and other planning agencies like Indian Himalayan States, Niti Aayog, Ministry of Environment are also acting in unison to achieve the goals, thereby preserving the ecosystem prevailing in Himalayan region. This is the main aim of the National Mission for Sustaining the Himalayan Ecosystem. Thank you.